we might get like higher.
She can't stand
there by herself. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem. We will have our very own Miss Araya play. Ladies and gentlemen, we need you behind the graduates, please.
Very proud principal of Edison High School, Principal Olga Ortiz.
afternoon, staff, parents, familia, esteemed guests, and the class of 2021. My name is Ms. Ortiz, and I am the proud principal of Edison High School. Today we have the honor to present to you all the graduating class of 2021. Please give them a round. Before I begin, we would like to take a moment to thank our parents and legal guardians. We thank you from the bottom of our souls for allowing us the privilege to educate your child in this digital space. There were many unknowns, many difficulties, but with your support and unconditional faith, we made the shift and stayed in this game. Thank you. I would also like to take the opportunity to thank administration and, most importantly, our Edison High School teachers. In spite of the difficult circumstances and tremendous challenges you have faced as educators, you truly embody the definition of a hero. We thank you, and the students thank you. We could not have done it without you. And lastly, I want to give a special shout out to Ms. Hayes, our senior class sponsor, and Ms. Morgan, for their love, compassion, and commitment to the class of 2021. Please give them a round. No matter what people say or think, our students exemplify academic excellence. This you see right here. We want to take this opportunity to acknowledge all of our students who will be moving forward to post-secondary experiences. If you will be attending college, university, or trade school, please stand up. Please give them a big round of applause. Oh my, what a year it has been. To adapt to change, things to fall apart. Many of us have been on a journey to rebuild our lives throughout this COVID pandemic. You all have endured so much struggle, but you have made it. You are here. We are humbled by your grace, perseverance, and resilience. Nothing in this universe is the same, but you, the class of 2021. You have defied gravity. In life, you have two choices, love or fear. Do not fear change. Begin to see yourself as the change that is going to come. You have the ability to create positive change because you, class of 2021, you are a force to be reckoned with. Remember, each of you have the ability to pursue your dreams and change your circumstances. Choose love above all else, and do not allow the last 17 months to define who you are. There have been many, many, many lessons learned this year, and I am going to share just a few. Loss. Loss can bring unexpected and enormous blessings. Hardships are opportunities for growth. I have been awed and inspired by the resiliency of your spirit. You never know how strong you are until you have to endure the undurable. Take notice of your blessings from those losses and be grateful for the ways in which those experiences have carved strength and wisdom into your being. Two, life. Live life now. Live it in the now. The present moment is where life occurs. We all reflect on the past and worry about the future. Don't waste your life second-guessing your decisions. Live life now. Live it passionately and live it fearlessly. Time is invaluable. Do not waste it. Love. Love is the currency of life. Love is an act of will. It is selfless and unconditional. Love is what matters most and what is remembered. It is love that connects us to one another and to the world around us, in life and beyond. So please be the best you and love fearlessly. Through our losses this year, we have extraordinary love. Remember, graduates, please choose to love unconditionally. Thank you.
El futuro lo que vendrá. El pasado fueron sucesos que ya ocurrieron, de los cuales se aprende de ellos. Siempre ha sido responsable con mi deber si haces una conducta impuesta por mi madre, que en realidad se lo agradezco hoy en día. Gracias a ella puedo terminar mi trabajo temprano y tener un tiempo para disfrutar, con ser lo que mi cuerpo me quisiera hacer. Si no fuera así, en circunstancias en las cuales, por no ser lo que pudiste hacer hoy, en vez de ayer, tomamos el camino que quizás fuera el que nunca quisieras tomar. Para mí, valorar tu tiempo, como decimos que lo puso el curso, es una de las cosas más importantes que podemos hacer. Tampoco insinuó que la vida es una carrera donde siempre tienes que ser el primero. Eso podría llegar a ser agotador, y te lo digo por experiencia. Tan solo aprendo lo bueno y lo malo que te ha pasado. Conserva lo bueno para disfrutar y así crear el mejor camino para tu futuro. En realidad, sin más nada que decir, quiero darle las gracias a mis compañeros, profesores y padres de todas las experiencias vividas y el apoyo que me han dado. Y aunque vayamos a tomar caminos diferentes, en realidad les deseo lo mejor a todos.
She boldly exclaims, "I am a walking empire. I am not a person. I am an experience. I don't just meet people. I happen to them. I am more than a woman. I am a world." She is dedicated, energetic, ambitious, and a star that keeps soaring and shining bright. Determined to complete and fulfill her God-given destiny and life's assignment, she lets nothing get in her way. Edison family, parents, families, friends, students, please welcome our keynote speaker, Ms. Tamara R. Hudson. Extremely challenging, and I realized how hard it was for you to push past all the disappointments a pandemic presents.
However, I know that you can attest to the trials and the obstacles that it did not stop you, but it only made you stronger. It built you in ways unimaginable, and you saw what was impossible turn into possibility. Each of you individually conquered the task at hand with strength and courage, which is admirable, and I personally applaud you for it. You are graduating as many things today with many honors, but the one thing I want you to add to your diploma and your honors today is that you are a survivor. Do me a favor as I take my seat and repeat after me. I am a survivor. Come on, say it louder than that. Say, I am a survivor. You have survived the worst of times so that you can face the best times of your life. The biggest congratulations to you, class of 2021. And remember, you win. I came to win. To fight. Conquer. You get the point. Congratulations.
They don't let go of the phone.
GPA and ETV.
award.
This award goes to a young lady, and we all had the pleasure to educate her. This award goes to Miss Lenuska Alvarez. To an amazing student who has achieved greatness in science. The Dr. Inta Marita Citron Science Award goes to Audrey Estrada Baid. To an amazing student who has shown excellence and greatness in attendance and grades. The Howard Rantanoff Athletics Award goes to none other than Ms. Nicole Lagos today. Just that. Lenuska Alvarez is a young lady who has persevered through all of the challenges of adulthood. remaining school year. She completed all of her coursework with a smile. And though she rose to the occasion and completed all four of the requirements of the bi-literacy test. It is my honor to recognize her achievement and honor her with this award, John Lowell. Our next award is the Alex LeBron Perseverance Award, and this actual award goes to two of our graduates today. This award is given to students who demonstrate patience and resiliency when faced with challenges. These students have accomplished all of their requirements with smiles on their faces and an eagerness to learn more. When faced with struggles, they weathered the storm. It is my honor to bestow this award on Miss Denise Mesa and Mr. Najee Sloan. Can I have your words?
Hargrove, this one basketball game where she was working the clock as a basketball manager, but in her cheerleading uniform, because she was also a cheerleader, and she came out and performed with us at halftime. And that just goes to show you the type of person that she is. So please welcome our valedictorian, none other than Laura.
Good morning, guests, family, friends, teachers, and staff. I want to start this off by saying how honored I am to be standing in front of you all at this very moment. As you all know, today we're here to congratulate Professor Simpson. My name is Laura, for those of you who don't know. I've been at Edison High School for 4 years and participating in the conference. I'm a club detective. Chances are, you've seen me before, but I was either running down the hallway getting somewhere or on the stage probably cheering. Today I will be taking you on a small timeline of my 4 years of high school. A bit over 4 years ago, I was removed from my mother's care by AHS services and placed in my father for a new chapter in my life.
Do you have a mask? Oh, yeah. Put it in front of her. Like, all right.
And for a long time, I gave myself room. Making that decision, to be honest, about what was going on in my mom's house, to be able to even know and choose to help myself was life changing, because that meant I lost my mother and my brother in the process. This was the start of my trip. This is the start of the challenges I faced on my own. I was going to do what I was doing at the time. 3 years ago, during the summer, and then just got kicked out.
See?
My uncle's house, and
I got the goodies.
Being kicked out at the age of 15 taught me that family doesn't mean they always set me back, but I think that's essential to me. That day I got kicked out, my uncle constantly called me on my knee, and I cried and cried and put myself into trash bags, wiping my tears. My father had to leave me to better himself emotionally and physically from the toxicity my family brought. I made the decision to figure out what I was going to do alone, but here in Philly, because I knew what opportunities I would receive if I stayed and kept working. I ended up staying with my sister in New Jersey for a few weeks and came back to Philly to stay with the family firm. 2 years ago, I got kicked out again during the school year. I was transitioning from one job to another. Being kicked out again helped me realize that only you can help yourself. I was hurt and worried mainly because it was my junior year. This is the time I started applying to colleges, but I was nonstop working just so I could support my basic needs. The day after I received the news I could no longer stay, I ended up working down the school that day. Give me a second, guys. Because I really didn't have any family to depend on and was lost someone to do. That day, I had a friend who stood with me the entire time just to make sure I was okay. She never stayed to let me stay with her, and now she's like my older sister. Thank you, Barbara, Misty, and Jacob. Barbara isn't here today, guys. Where? Oh. 1 year ago, I was finally okay somewhat. I had a roof over my head, I was eating well, working still, going to school, and then COVID-19 decided to knock on my door. Followed by that pain reading. I was out of a job for a few months and unmotivated for school. I remember having to go on a Google Meet with Ruddick and Dominguez for PGC, and we talked about what was decided to do a program with the school district of Philadelphia called the Senior Year Only Program, which was dual enrollment and helped me gain the motivation I needed to finish up my last year's trying. Today, I'm here in front of you all, and I have earned 28 free college credits. I'm the top of my class.
A couple of people that would like to say goodbye to you.
And one of them is someone that you guys have seen around the school, if you have been here since ninth grade. Although it is your day, I must share that it is his last year with us as well. So he will be saying goodbye to you guys. He wrote this poem especially for you. And I'm going to hear a very, very, very loud round of applause for our wonderful counselor, Mr. Humphrey.
Surf undeniable. and you paved the way for more life victories. Today, you celebrate, and we will say your name, because your part in this world means it will never be the same. Today, we celebrate, and we thank you, you, and all of you for letting us celebrate with you. Or as Estamos celebrando.
Miss Pereira and Miss Maggie said I could not make them cry this year, so I'm going to keep crying and hopefully I'll make myself cry. So welcome to all of the families and friends that have come here to celebrate the class of 2021. It was with your support that they have made it here today. And it got me thinking about the support of my own family and what they provide. My mom always made sure to use everyday situations to teach me life lessons that I still care about. And I want to share them with you today. We're going to do a little Spanglish here, right? So, I'm Dominican, with Dominican parents. So you know que yo empecé el oficio desde pequeña. She would have us wash dishes, sweep. One day it was my turn to hang the laundry for the first time. We had a line going down the hallway in our apartment in New York, but it was too high for me to reach. So I started tossing all my clothes up there, hoping that it would hang. Check on me, she says, mira muchacha, usa la sustancia gris. Use your gray matter. The gray matter in your brain is responsible for processing information. She explained that if I would have taken a second to stop and process, I would have come up with a better solution, like finding a school to stay. She always pushed me to think, if something doesn't make sense, how do you make it work? Your learning is just beginning. The last 12 years was nothing compared to what life will teach you. So you can choose to be passive and let things happen to you, or you can get out there and learn, question, inquire, make it make sense. When I got my first car, I was really excited, but I wasn't prepared for all of the money I would have to spend on random car issues, and I'm sure anyone that is a car owner knows how that goes. At one point, I needed some major work on my car, and I found a shop that would do the work for pretty cheap. But it was kind of a sketchy shop. Then I had this really solid, reliable mechanic, but it was a little bit more expensive. I was talking to my brother, and as he was giving me advice, he said, no te olvides lo que te dijo mami. Lo barato sale caro. Things that may seem cheap now end up being more expensive in the long run. I always carried that with me, and I apply it to my work ethic. Some of you sitting here today had a rough start to the school year for one reason or another. You were not paying your educational dues, showing up to class, turning in your work, communicating with your teachers. So at the end of the school year, it got really expensive for you. That meant some really late nights, talking to your teachers all day, every day, waiting nervously to see if you got that passing average. And the truth is, that some of your classmates aren't here today because that price was a little bit too high. There is no easy way out in real life. You have to make sacrifices and you have to put in the work. My last jump came from my mom, but it wasn't talking with Ms. Berganti and Mr. Aquino that I was reminded of it. No haga mañana lo que pueda hacer hoy. Don't do tomorrow what you can do today. I think one thing that we all learned in this pandemic is that tomorrow is not promised. We cannot take this life that we live for granted. So do not wait for tomorrow to do what you can do today. We always think, well, there's more time, until there isn't. So do not wait to be amazing. Do not wait to make things happen. Do not wait to change your life or the lives of others. And I cannot wait to hear about all of the awesome things that you have done. Class of 2021, I love you and thank you. Okay. But it takes a whole team of people to make all of this happen. But literally, if it was not for your senior sponsor, I don't know if we would have been able to pull off that amazing, yes, started right now. I don't know if we would have been able to pull off that amazing prom. I don't know if we would have been able to pull this off. I think I talked to this person more than I've talked to anyone else in the past couple of months. Saying farewell to you now is your senior sponsor, none other than Ms. Hayes.
Se volvieron locas ahí.
Thank you.
You know where they're coming in through? This way or that, or the other side?
I wanna say this side, but let me
this way.
Nakaya McKnight. Tamaja DeShield. Laura Alvarez. Nadira Saunders. Bianca Perez. Araya Clay. Nicole Lemos Davila. Ninoshka Alvarez. Audrey Estrella Maggi. Carlos Alicea Rodriguez. Hiram Velasquez. Michael Fambro. Mariel Sanchez Martinez. Davidson Marin Pineda. Ana Figueroa. Joanna Leal. Zachary Cruz. Elani Rodriguez. Angel Terrero. Yating Zhang.
Sakira Miller. Jasmine West.
Ginelli Soler Rodriguez. Next row, please stand.
Come on now, stand up. Second row, second row.
And let's start walking this way, guys.
That knife.
Michael Calo Cruz. Angel Rodriguez. Selena Gonzalez. Ulises Ortiz. Jaylene Perez. Nadir Monroe. Najee Sloan.
Carlos De Jesus.
Jennifer Sedano Mojica.
Where's the card?
Yasir Curtis. Shariel Ojeda Larapuente. Desma Sanchez. Yorgelis Diaz Suazo. Yelena Lopez Vasquez. Kamar Porter. Ray Romero. Dominic Ortiz. Marilyn Rodriguez. Next row, please stand. Ashanti Hines. Denise Massa.
Angel Pavon.
Jordan Belmont. Nashalis Soto. Chahad Maldonado. Ángel Herrera. Qué lindo. Dana Zayas. Nazaya Donaldson. Taria Grimes. Corey Avery. Hazel Mendez. Andy Santiago. Jonathan Marquez. Emma Marie Martinez. Melvin Castillo. Diego Villafranca Vanegas. Imani Diaz. Maya Thompson. Tanaya Ashford. Kristen Burton. Kirk Jones. Omar Velasquez. Nathan Pagan. Elisa Robles. Jalila Cruz. Soliani Villanueva. Alcides Sanchez. George Gonzalez. Donovan Gonzalez. Sherelle Hall. Malaya Torres. Tyreek Fowler Bronek. Marcus Fuggs. William Ortiz Rodriguez. Deion Medley Dukes. Samantha Breno Mallon. Daphne Torres. Bryant Lockhart. Crystal Santiago. Niviani Cruz. Clandelis. Kiandelis, I apologize. Polo. Shaid Taylor. Tamir Kervin. Shakur Garvin Dillon. Yarinexi Vargas. Joshua O's. David Santana. Julius O'Hara. Luciano Mato. Jesse Lanzo. Nicole Saez. Janeline Santos. Jose Medina. Samaj Merrow. Avante Mitchell. Brian Leon Rodriguez. Tyshawn Reynolds. Amaria Coleman. Lamont Harris. Lena Pino Castro. Angie Matu. Kaya Hargrove.
Pedro Rivera Rojas. Tyrese Costley.
Sarah McStay. Jason Vargas. Elijah Mendez. Zaki Scutching. Christopher Fortson. Miguel Lebron Rodriguez.
Ella Rosario.
Luis Ventura. Chelvin Castillo. Victor García. Enrique Cruz. Joshua García. Mary Brown. Jalen Williams. Ryan Aguilar. Beverly Herrera Gutierrez.
Tatiana Spring. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yanisha Woodson. Woo. Joseph Rivera. Mercedes Garvin.
Oh my God.
Isaiah Rosado. Emmanuel Robinson. Nasheen Lee. Kwamir Coffey. Amin De La Cruz. John C. Torres. Jacob Rivera. Luis Carrera. Isaiah Brown. Giovanni Diaz Ortiz.
Please remain standing for our alma mater. Once I read the proclamation, you will also have to go into the gym to pick up your diploma. The way we entered is the way we exit, okay? Great. Parents, we will need you to wait until your graduate exits the gym. Right. Upon the recommendation of faculty, and by the power vested in me by the School District of Philadelphia and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I have the honor to bestow upon you your high school diploma and proclaim that you are now graduates of Addison High. Woo! I had to take a selfie, sorry. Music. Music. Sorry, music. 1 second. One second. It's always happens.